Hi, I'm Torben Janssen from thoughtsonjava.org. Today I want to show you how to implement a conditional audit with Hibernate Envers. Envers automatically integrates with Hibernate ORM and provides a powerful and easy-to-use solution to write an audit log. As I described in previous videos, you just need to add Envers to your class path and annotate your entities with audited. It will then document all insert, update, and delete operations, and you can even perform complex queries on your audited data and customize the revision information. Sounds quick and easy, right? Well, it is, as long as you audit all changes performed on an entity. But implementing a conditional audit requires more work. By default, Hibernate Envers registers a set of event listeners, which are triggered by Hibernate ORM. You need to replace these listeners to customize Envers audit capabilities. Hibernate Envers provides a set of listeners, which are triggered by the event types you can see here on the slide. Let's say I'm auditing book entities and I want to ignore all updates of books which are not published. These are all book entities which publishing date attribute is null. I need to replace the existing listeners for events of event type pre-update and event type post-update. That's a lot easier than you might expect. Let's take a look at the book entity first. As you can see here, I annotated this entity with audited, so that Hibernate Envers audits all changes. That's all you need to do if you want to write a standard audit which documents all changes. But we only want to audit published entities, and that requires a few custom event listeners. Hibernate Envers provides the Envers pre-update event listener impl. It already implements all the required logic to write the audit information for update operations. The only thing you need to do is to extend this class and ignore all update operations which you don't want to document in the audit log. I do that in the MyEnverse pre-update event listener impl class. It extends Enverse pre-update event listener impl and overrides the onPreUpdate method. Within that method, I check if the event was triggered for a book entity and if the publishing date is null. If that's the case, I ignore the event, and in all other cases, I just call the method on the superclass. And you can replace the listener of the event type post-update event in the same way. The only difference is that you now need to extend the Envers post-update event listener impl class. I did that here. Okay. You have a custom listener implementation which ignore all changes to book entities which don't have a publishing date. You now just have to tell Hibernate Envers to use your listeners instead of the default ones. You can do that by providing your implementation of Hibernate's integrator interface. The easiest way to do that is to copy and adapt the Envers integrator class. Hibernate Envers uses this class by default. All event listeners are registered in the integrate method. In this example, I just want to replace the listener for the event type pre-update and event type post-update events. So I register my implementations instead of Envers default ones. You can implement this part as it is required by your application. You can replace all of Envers listeners, don't register listeners for some events, or register listeners for other Hibernate event types. The last thing you need to do to use your custom event listeners is to register your integrator implementation. You can do that by adding the fully qualified name of your class in the metainf services org.hibernate.integrator.spi.integrator file. Okay, that's all. Let's give it a try. This test case persists a new book entity without a publishing date in the first transaction, updates the title in the second transaction, and sets the publishing date in the third transaction. I only replaced the listeners for the event type pre-update and event type post-update events. Hibernate Envers therefore audits the insert operation of the first transaction. But you can see that in the second transaction, the custom event listener implementations ignored the update event, and when the third transaction sets the publishing date, the custom listeners delegate the event handling to Envers listener implementation and adds a record to the audit log. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like a cheat sheet for this video and an ebook about the Java 8 support in Hibernate 5. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. And if you like today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!